So you're looking for a new mattress. It's time to find the perfect mattress for you. If so, you've probably come across two of the most popular types of mattresses, memory foam and hybrid. So today I want to talk about what exactly is a memory foam mattress and what is a hybrid mattress. Who should get one over the other and which one is the right one for you. But first I want to say Casper financially supported this video and also sent me this great Casper hybrid mattress to try out. I was a big fan of this mattress and big thank you to Casper here. But now let's talk about memory foam versus hybrid. So memory foam is made out of a polymer called polyurethane, and you're going to find this material in objects like car seats, sofas, and more importantly, like today, mattresses. So memory foam has this kind of like soft, slowly moving quicksand feel, so you slowly sink into the mattress. Now a hybrid mattress, on the other hand, is going to have soft comfort layers on top or some type of foam comfort layer on top. That could be latex, could be memory foam, or a blend of the two, or some other type of poly foam. Beneath that, you're gonna have supportive coils. So for example, I'm on the Casper Hybrid right now. So you have a couple layers on top. You're gonna have a latex-like foam, layer memory foam beneath that, and a zone transition layer beneath that. Beneath that all, you're gonna have your supportive coil. So that is a hybrid construction. So what are the differences between a memory foam mattress and a hybrid mattress? Well, first off, it's going to be in the construction. So memory foam mattresses, as we're talking about today, is going to be an all foam mattress. A hybrid mattress, on the other hand, is going to have coils in it. The coils are going to make it very, very different. First thing it's going to do is it might drive up the price just a little bit. In general, a hybrid mattress is going to cost more than an all foam mattress, than a memory foam mattress. This isn't always true, but it usually is. It's going to do a couple of things for your hybrid mattress though, and it's definitely worth that extra investment. First off, it's gonna make it more supportive, so it can handle heavier weights. It's also gonna make it more durable, so make it a longer lasting mattress. You pay more money up front, but it should last for a longer amount of time. Hybrid mattresses are also gonna be more breathable in general than memory foam mattresses. Last but not least, ease of mobility. So with memory foam mattresses, I've had this experience where I sink in too far, I am stuck, I can't move at all. With hybrid mattresses, you have less chances of that happening. With the coils, they don't let you sink in too far. The mattresses are usually more responsive overall, so it is easier to move around in general. So what are the benefits and drawbacks of memory foam? First off, memory foam is great with pressure relief. So you slowly sink into the mattress, you feel little pressure on your joints and your key areas. It's also awesome at handling motion transfer. So if you sleep with a partner, you get up at night to go to the bathroom, your movement shouldn't disturb them. And off of that as well, memory foam is not a noisy mattress. So when you don't have coils in the mattress, it doesn't squeak. So if you do move around at night, you shouldn't disturb yourself or your partner. But at the same time, there are some drawbacks. So first off, memory foam is known for trapping heat. And this is a big issue for me. I'm a hot sleeper. Lying down on top of a memory foam mattress, it traps my heat, kind of directs it back at me, and so I overheat at night, wake up sweaty and clammy. Not always a great experience. It's also sometimes harder to move around. So memory foam is not always the most responsive. You can feel stuck in your mattress. I've also had this experience. And then last but not least, memory foam is not always the most durable material. So depending on the density of the memory foam, it may sag more quickly than a hybrid mattress. So definitely something to consider. Now, what are the benefits and drawbacks of hybrid mattresses? Well, first off, hybrid mattresses are very breathable. You have coils at the bottom there, allows for more airflow, shouldn't trap so much heat as memory foam, shouldn't sleep so hot. In addition, they're going to be more supportive. So the coils add some serious support to the mattress, should be able to handle heavier weights than a memory foam mattress. But at the same time, you have a soft comfort layer on top, so it's going to be a good balance of comfort and support. For instance, with the Casper Hybrid here, some soft comfort layers on top, beneath that supportive coil, so good for all three sleeping positions. And then finally, durability. The coils are going to add some serious life to your mattress. They may cost a little bit more up front, but it should last for a longer amount of time. In terms of hybrid drawbacks, first off, you have price. In general, a hybrid is going to cost more than a memory foam mattress. You have coils in the mattress as well and comfort layers on top, so you're getting more out of it, but it might cost more up front. In addition, it can be more cumbersome, so hybrid mattresses can be heavier than straight memory foam mattresses, so whether you're moving your mattress across the room, across town, or across the country, it might be more difficult. Hybrid mattresses aren't always as good at handling motion transfer. So if you do move around at night, your partner might feel more of her movements on a hybrid mattress. So right now you might be wanting to say, Martin, tell me which one I should get. I can't tell you exactly which one to get, but I can give you some hints. So with memory foam, first off, if you want to slowly sink into your mattress, kind of feel that quick, sandy, slow moving feel, memory foam is definitely right for you. It's more like you're sleeping in their mattress versus on top. So if you like that, definitely check out memory foam. In addition, it's usually a better fit for side sleepers. I'm a side sleeper. I love lying down in a memory foam mattress, kind of slowly sinking in, feeling the pressure melt away on my shoulders and my hips. So side sleepers, those with pain issues, definitely check out memory foam. Also, in general, memory foam mattresses are gonna save you some money. They're usually priced lower than a hybrid mattress, so if you don't wanna spend quite so much money up front, definitely check out memory foam. Then last but not least, if you sleep with a partner, memory foam in general is better at cutting down on motion transfers. So whether you or your partner move around a lot at night, you go to the bathroom a lot at night like I do, you shouldn't wake up your partner so much on a memory foam mattress. So who should pick a hybrid mattress? First off, if you prefer to sleep on top of your mattress, you don't want to sink in quite so far, with a hybrid mattress, you usually sleep more on top. There's also more bounce with a hybrid mattress, so you have less chance of getting stuck. So if you're usually worried about kind of mobility issues, you get stuck in your mattress a lot, this happens to me on memory foam, hybrids are usually better at addressing this issue. In addition, a hybrid mattress usually features a better balance of comfort and support. So the support of coils and the comfort of those top layers as well. And that makes it a better match for all three sleeping positions. On your back and your stomach, you get support there. On your side, the comfort layers give you some good pressure relief as well. It's also a better match for hot sleepers. In general, you have more airflow from the coil, so you don't heat up quite so much as you do on a memory foam mattress. And then there's durability. In general, a hybrid mattress is going to be more durable than a memory foam mattress. The coils add some serious durability, so while you spend some more money up front, it should be a better long-term investment. Now, it's also a good match for heavier people. So I'm a larger person, I have more support needs. I'm 230 pounds, so if you're my weight or larger, definitely check out a hybrid mattress. By now, you should know which one is right for you, a memory foam mattress or a hybrid mattress. But if you want some more help, I definitely check out mattressclarity.com. We have a lot of great reviews and comparisons to help you find the right mattress for you. Again, if you have any specific questions, you want a personal recommendation, just leave a comment below.